No other motorcycle manufacturer has been as busy as Honda two-wheelers. Over the past year or so, the Japanese giant has launched a heap of new products, and we're not just talking small BS6 updates. Case in point, the new Hornet 2.0, a completely new motorcycle for our market. Unfortunately, due to logistical issues, we haven't got media test bikes for most of Honda's new launches so far. However, when it came to the new Hornet 2.0, we just couldn't wait anymore, so we went and found a bike to review. The Hornet 2.0 is based on the international spec CB190R, but with plenty of changes for India. It brings in new styling, a new chassis, better suspension, and a bigger engine. Apart from the name, there isn't much else that it carries over from its predecessor, the CB Hornet 160R, and that's why we're so keen to see what this new Honda is all about. Since everything really is new, let's peel back the layers from the top, starting with the styling. The overall silhouette is similar to the international CB190R, but most of the body panels have been changed for India. The LED headlamp is new as well, while the gold-colored USD fork also stands out as a USP in this segment. Meanwhile, a new engine cowl adds to the sporty stance. Viewed from the front three quarters, the bodywork with its larger tank extensions looks taut and muscular, but the fuel tank still holds the same 12 liters of petrol. The ignition key slot is now placed at the front of the fuel tank, which is something you normally see in more expensive machines. Over at the side, a new split seat setup creates a more sporty appearance, and when you move to the rear, the new quarter panels have a more interesting design as well. However, they don't change the fact that the rear section with its X-shaped LED tail lamp is very similar to the old Hornet. Facing the rider is a negative LCD display with 5 levels of adjustable brightness, 2 trip meters, a battery voltage meter, and a gear position indicator. And finally, the switchgear is still quite basic looking, but it's a definite improvement over the old Hornet, and you now get hazard lights as well as an engine kill switch.
It all comes together quite nicely. That gold USD fork gives the bike an impressive Street Fighter stance, but there are a few details that I wish were nicer. For example, this side panel is quite flimsy. And these body colored mirrors, they aren't actually painted. They're blue color plastic, and when you look at them up close, they're a little bit tacky.
A few details aside, the new Hornet looks more like a sporty motorcycle, and it gets a new bigger engine to back that up. Displacing 184.4cc, this fuel-injected engine is 22cc up on the old bike, and it also manages to produce a little more power and torque.
We already know this isn't very impressive on paper. There's no four-valve head, no DOHC, no liquid cooling, not even an oil cooler, and it uses a 5-speed gearbox. Alright, but what's this engine like on the road?
The very first impression is that of familiarity. This engine has that same smooth feel with a whiny intake sound that is typical of small capacity Hondas. Our bike had a fresh engine, but refinement levels were still impressive, with just a mild vibration to be felt in the foot pegs and seat near the 9,500 RPM redline. Peak power is actually rated a little lower at 8,500 RPM, and you do feel the engine start to get a bit flat above this. Nevertheless, the fueling is smooth, the engine pulls cleanly from low revs, and there's a nice surge that develops when you cross 6,000 RPM. Mid-range performance is clearly the goal, and the Hornet 2.0 feels enjoyably punchy at moderate speeds. We didn't get to test high-speed performance on the highway, but the bike should be able to sit at about 90 kph without feeling like it's working too hard. As to what the accurate acceleration and top speed figures are, that'll have to wait till we can test this bike with a V-Box data logger. Beyond flat-out performance, the 5-speed gearbox is smooth and light, as is the clutch action, and these are both things that you will appreciate within the city. Honda has also kept the gearing quite short, and the engine is flexible. I even found myself absent-mindedly starting off from second gear a couple of times, and the bike didn't seem to mind.
I like how this engine feels, but while it certainly isn't slow, it's not surprisingly quick either. Again, only a V-Box test will give us the full numbers. But from what I've experienced today, this motorcycle feels about as quick as a Hero Xtreme 200R, and I don't think it's as fast as the 200s from either TVS or Bajaj.
While that's an answer we don't have yet, what is certain is that the Hornet 2.0 handles better than any 150 or 160cc Honda commuter motorcycle that has come before it. It only takes a couple of minutes to realize that the suspension setup isn't soft and soggy like most Honda 160cc machines. In fact, it's actually a bit on the firm side, and the same can be said for the rider's seat. Now, the ride quality isn't harsh, but it's not plush either, especially over rough and rutted roads. In terms of practicality though, there's plenty of ground clearance, so you won't have to worry about potholes or bad roads. What comes as a happy surprise is how quickly the new Hornet wants to lean into corners. The low 142 kg curb weight definitely helps, but this bike is eager to change direction, and the fact that it now runs fatter tires than before has had no negative effect on its agility.
The new Hornet is nimble, but it's also confident when leaned over. Now, we didn't get very high-speed corners to experience today, but on these smooth, winding country roads, those new Maxxis Extra Max tires found good amounts of grip, and I had plenty of fun.
Perhaps the only thing that still feels a little too soft is the bite from the front disc brake, and the lever needs a hard pull to slow down in a hurry. It's also a bit of a downer that this bike offers only single-channel ABS.
Of course, not everybody wants to ride their bike like that, and especially not all the time. Comfort is important too, and in that respect, the Hornet seems to have its ergonomics sorted.
The riding position is upright with just a tiny lean forward to the handlebar, while the foot pegs are slightly rear set. The seat height is decent too, and overall, this is a bike that should fit riders of most shapes and sizes. Now, as we draw to the conclusion, it is time to talk about value for your money. At Rs 1.27 lakh ex showroom, the Hornet 2.0 costs just 1,500 rupees less than the TVS Apache RTR 200 and about 2,700 less than the Bajaj Pulsar NS 200. It can't match either in terms of specification, and it also lacks features like Bluetooth connectivity or a slipper clutch. In fact, TVS has just launched the RTR 200 with single-channel ABS, and that bike actually costs 3,500 less than the Honda. So no, value for money is not a particularly strong point here.
But sheer value isn't the only thing that matters, and Honda has made an enjoyable motorcycle here. I'm particularly relieved that Honda hasn't gone down the same old path of making a boring commuter with fancy bodywork. This bike actually has a sporting feel to it, and that's convinced us that it deserves a proper comparison with its seriously capable rivals.